Thank you for clicking on NewsSentinel.com. Multimedia editors Justin Kenny, Dan Vance here to talk some high school basketball. We have boys action. We have girls action. We have all kinds of excitement coming up this weekend. We're going to start with the boys and some two big games, one in the NE8, one in the ACAC. We'll start with East Noble at New Haven. East Noble's already clinched a share of the conference championship. They can win it outright with a victory over New Haven. New Haven, if they can beat East Noble and then win against Leo in a week or two, they can tie for the conference championship. So a lot on the line this Friday at New Haven.
Yeah, it's going to be a really interesting game to really see. We keep talking about, can East Noble get to the next step and match that next level? New Haven's the team they got to beat. It's kind of the benchmark in the conference, and they have been athletically for several years. It's obviously for the conference championship in ways. East Noble knows they get a share of it, but you never want to share that conference title.
Yeah. Let's look forward a little bit with East Noble. 16-1, I believe, only one loss for the season. If they host the sectional, they have played Bishop Dwenger, they have played DeKalb, two potential conference opponents, but you look at Carroll and Northside as the favorites in that sectional. East Noble, though, do they have a realistic shot of winning this thing?
I think as we get deeper, they do more and more. We're seeing the depth of this team, and the depth in position-wise. There's not a team that's just full of shooters. We've seen a lot in East Noble in the past. We've seen East Noble that's really deep inside. This team can spread out the floor a little bit, and that's something that's dangerous to, especially a team like Northside, and a little bit to Carroll, too.
Looking at New Haven, this is a team that kind of, once we feel that they've hit their stride, they regress a little bit and have a loss. And this is a game that's big for them in terms of conference, but also with sectionals looming in just a couple weeks, where is New Haven right now?
I think they're sitting comfortably. I think they're comfortable even going into this East Noble game. Brakar Clark has been hitting his stride, shooting the ball, shot the ball very well earlier this week in a win. Zach Latham's been scoring at a pretty good clip. So they have scorers in place. Early in the season, it was kind of, let's see, feel it out, see who's going to be our big-time scorer, big-time offensively. New Haven defensively is always going to be tough. They're always going to get in passing lanes, get after loose balls. You know that you have that identity. You're athletic. Your defense is strong. They needed to establish an offensive identity, and they've really done that with Clark and Latham.
Can East Noble wrap up an undefeated season in the NEA? We'll find out Friday night at New Haven. Also Friday night in the ACAC, Battle of Undefeateds in terms of conference records, Heritage at Jay County. Heritage, we felt, was the team that's been playing the most consistent, but Jay County there, if they can get a win, they can win this conference.
Yeah, and Jay County's been playing really good basketball. Cole Stiegelman has been playing fantastic most of the year, but especially since the ACAC tournament. The Schlechty brothers have been playing very well. Heritage is just right there, and they're limiting possessions, limiting shots per possession, limiting scoring, and the things that Heritage has done so well, they haven't really had a problem. No one's been able to challenge them offensively. Jay County's got some weapons. It's probably the best chance in the ACAC for anyone to challenge Heritage offensively.
Heritage, going into this week, the second best defensive scoring average in the entire state. Angola is actually number one. But when you look at this Heritage team, not much in the way of offensive firepower. They score just enough and get enough defensive stops to win games. This defense has been tremendous all season long.
Yeah, and it's going to continue to be. We saw it from day one when they scrimmaged Northside. Their defense against Northside looked fantastic. They know how to slow other teams down and make other teams play their pace, their speed, their game, and it's been a benefit all year long, and very few teams have gotten the better of Heritage.
It doesn't get headlines. It's not sexy, but defense wins games. Heritage has been able to win quite a bit this year because of their defense. Okay, Saturday, regional Saturday on the girls' side. We used to have in single class, you'd have to win twice regional, twice semi-state, twice state. Now this is the only round of the postseason tournament, and my favorite, actually, where you have to win twice in one day. Start in 4A. At Kokomo, Southside and Carroll will play in the first semifinal, Carmel and Zionsville in the second one. The winners meet at 8 o'clock in the evening. Let's look at the Southside game against Carroll. Carroll was able to take care of business, I don't want to say easily, but in convincing fashion against Northrop in the sectional championship game last Saturday. Second time around with these two teams, does Carroll have what it takes to hang with South?
It's going to be interesting. They have to do what they did against Northrop. And I think Carroll learned a lot from their previous Northrop game, from their Southside games, because those teams were so similar, and being able to use their poise to avoid the pressure of Northrop. That's what they have to do here. When they played in the SAC Holiday Tournament, Southside was able to pressure Carroll into making a lot of mental mistakes. in a game that would have been very close had they not made those mental mistakes, because Carroll does a lot of things well. Did they learn enough? That's interesting. Also, Southside, you know, it's a team that's rolling because they have all this momentum. Did their momentum slow last week? You beat Homestead. That's your toughest game in sectionals. Your next toughest game, but a significant drop-off, the win over Huntington North.
Yes.
And then Saturday's championship game over Muncie Central doesn't present much of a challenge. So can Southside, you know, did they feel a little more lax towards the end of the week? And how do you raise that up, that level up this week going into, you know, I think we've called it the regional of death for several years.
Yeah.
It's the toughest regional in this state, arguably, to get through.
Yeah, and, you know, Kelly Damon and Laney Steckler had tremendous sectional weeks for Carroll. They're definitely going to have to continue that hot play on Saturday morning. Southside or Carroll, which team has the best chance of knocking off Carmel, which is inevitably, barring a huge upset, will be the team that either one of those teams faces on Saturday night?
Well, I'm going to preface it with, I wouldn't count Zionsville out yet.
I will.
Matty Nolan shoots 53% from the field for them. They're a very good team. They're not Carmel.
Yeah.
I wouldn't count them out, but yeah, I would say that about 85% of me says Carmel's going. That two-headed dragon of Amy Dilk and Tomi Taiwo for Carmel is very, very difficult. And these teams have seen it. Southside's seen it this year. Homestead saw it. It's very, very tough. I think Southside has more weapons, but they're going to have to get hot. If Southside plays Carmel in the championship game, you're going to have J.C. Jones and Shamari Tyson and Shamari Jackson hitting from the outside, kind of like what they did against Homestead and Sectionals. Shoot well from the outside. It opens up the inside for Tanise Chapman, for Alea Chapman, for Makiba Jones to do what they do. They have to open up the floor and space the floor out. I think that's the only way you beat Carmel.
Yeah, and I like Southside's chances in terms of earlier in the season, they lose to Homestead. They understand what they need to change. They come back and beat them in sectionals. They lost to Carmel down there in the regular season. They saw what they have to do to beat a Carmel, or at least be more competitive against Carmel. So maybe they're able to take the lessons learned and apply them to Saturday night. 3A at Columbia City, another area showdown in the semifinals, Fairfield and Concordia. Marion and Hamilton Heights, the other showdown the winners will play in the evening. So we look at Concordia. And I saw them last Friday look very impressive in the second half against Leo. Chancey's Craig, we've seen her growth throughout the season, the 6'2 freshman. And we talked so much about Carissa Garcia, and for good reason, she's that team's leading scorer. But Chancey's Craig's improvement throughout the year really gives them an inside threat to take some of the pressure off Carissa Garcia, where they can now play a true inside-out type offense.
Yeah, I think that's where Fairfield is going to find the biggest challenge, is who do they have to match up with Chantice Craig. And that's been Concordia's benefit. Girls get to the basket. Guard-heavy teams get to the basket, but then they cannot finish because Chantice Craig is there. Her sister, Chastity, is there. You know, this is not a team lacking for size. And Fairfield, very good guard play. Janine Schwartz, Erica Zook have been really good for Fairfield all year. Who do they match up against the inside presence of Concordia? And do they have anybody that can offensively match up with Carissa Garcia, who should just flat-out score from anywhere on the floor?
Yeah, and we talk so much about Chantice Craig and Carissa Garcia. Elizabeth Hetler may be in the position to capitalize with all the Fairfield attention on the true big Chantice Craig. Hetler's kind of that person that can clean up a lot of things for Concordia as well.
Yeah, and Hetler can do multiple things because she's more in the vein, I would say, of a Sydney Graber or Homestead, that she can step out. She's not a prolific shooter, but if Libby Hetler has to step out and handle the ball in the perimeter, she can do it. She can drive to the basket well. She can do a lot of other things very well. So that's kind of another, you know, interesting point, is if Fairfield sends too much to the post, Libby Hetler can step out. And again, we're talking about expanding the floor earlier with Southside. That gives Concordia the opportunity to expand the floor a lot.
10 o'clock, Fairfield and Concordia. Noon will be Marion and Hamilton Heights winners at night. Dan Vance and Shooter will be out at Columbia City. All right, moving to 2A at Winamax Central. Noble and Bluffton will play in the first semifinal at 11 o'clock. What do we expect between the Cougars and the Tigers?
Well, it's going to be a very interesting game. Central Noble, we talked all year, Sydney Freeman, Malia Leatherman, are very dangerous. And how you prepare for those two, I got a chance to go out to Bluffton practice earlier this week. What impressed me was this is a team that, going into regionals, first sectional win since 1998, and Monday afternoon, they were in there practicing fundamentals, doing the little things, making sure that they were, you know, just tightening up all these things they need to do, knowing that we're going to prepare for them. And Coach Karl Grau talked to me about that. We're going to prepare for Central Noble. But they're a team that's coming in and wants to make sure they do all the little things right. Let's take care of the little things. And that's what got them here, winning that sectional, and a tough sectional that they won, getting by Canterbury in the championship game in a very, very close game. Do the little things right. Bluffton's kind of hinging on that. Central Noble is kind of more of your let's make big plays. Let's do the wow factor things with Freeman and Leatherman. So it's kind of a clash of styles in a lot of ways. But you also have two head coaches that were coached in high school by the same coach. So I think you're going to see some styles that are similar in ways. It'll be a really interesting game.
As Dan said, he was able to visit with Coach Karl Grau and Bluffton earlier this week.
They're obviously very good. They've got two outstanding players in Freeman and Leatherman. And they've also got very solid players around them. They're going to be a unique challenge for us. But we're going to try to see what we can do in terms of watching film and what we need to try to take away and limit and so forth. And then what we can do offensively against what they do defensively. So it'll be a unique matchup. Obviously that's going to evolve over the course of the week. But they're a good team. And so we look at the challenge. They won their regional last year. And so, they've been to a semi-state, so they've been here. They've had that experience, and this is our first time through it. So we're going to try to see if we can't make this just an atmosphere where we just go and have nothing to lose, and let's just go play. I mean, we develop our own players. I mean, we work with who we have, and we really have stressed fundamentals all the way through our program. And certain things that we want to have done. Obviously offensive skills are important, and learning, how to be able to become a basketball player and how to become a Lady Tiger and what it means to be a Lady Tiger and be a great teammate. Now, we really focus on a lot of things too that are off the court. How do you treat each other? How do you handle adversity? How do you, go through tough times and stick together? And that's been a big thing. That was really the last thing we really have tried to overcome in terms of just trying to take that next step forward. But the one thing we're preaching this week is let's not be satisfied with where we are and continue to try to excel and see what we can do in the regional this weekend.
Of course, the winner of Central Noble and Bluffton will play the winner of Bishop Knoll and North Judson in the championship game at Winnemac on Saturday evening. A little bit about that matchup between two teams that most people aren't familiar with.
It's going to be a really good game. The thing for this is we talked about before, I think during football season, I think Woodland had to go to North Judson for a game. It's such a long trip to North Judson. North Judson is about 20 minutes away from this regional site, and everybody else has a long trip over there. So North Judson kind of has the jump in that regard. The interesting thing about this regional, 9 seniors between all 4 teams, very young teams. Both of these teams have 4 freshmen playing for them. So very young teams, inexperienced, but very good teams. They score well. And it's going to be an interesting. They're more of a Central Noble. I think Bluffton's kind of maybe an outlier in the regards of having premier scoring. Bluffton kind of, does it by group effort versus these teams do it more of a scoring effort. And freshman Courtney Blake for North Judson, 17 points per game. She's probably the best individual scorer outside of Central Noble in this, and I think that really kind of propels North Judson. They're a very strong team, very fundamental, but they score the basket very well.
Central Noble and Bluffton at 11, Bishop Knoll and North Judson at 1, championship game at 8 o'clock Saturday night. 1A at Tipton, Rockville, and Southern Wells. Southern Wells is competing for a regional title. Who would have thought that this time last week?
Nobody.
Okay.
Well, it's possible. Southern Wells is coming out of a sectional, with all due respect to Southern Wells, a sectional where I don't think any team had a winning record. And so you had to come out of it at 1A. Southern Wells does play a tougher schedule than most 1A schools playing in the ACAC. Those are 2A schools, 3A schools. But they're a little bit tougher schools than what you see at 1A. They just kind of happen to luck out in the sectional draw and not really luck out having to play Rockville.
Yeah, you get Rockville and then try Central, await the winner of that one. So going to be very difficult for Southern Wells to get out of there. The other 1A regional of note at Caston, Lakewood Park playing North White at 10 o'clock. Lakewood Park gets out their first sectional championship ever.
Ever.
I want to say. So yes. 1 year after the boys get their first sectional title ever, the girls are able to do it 1 year later. So about the Panthers, a little bit about their run here to regional.
Well, it starts, and luckily for them, now does not end with Chloe Jolloff, the freshman. And you and I have talked about her at some points this year. Teams did very well in sectionals to try to limit her, which is good because it forces other players to step up. Hayden Fowler had a really good sectional. Grayson Fetters had a really good sectional. So they're a team that's learning. They're deep. but still young. Obviously, when your best player is a freshman, you still have some experience. They've never been to this level. So how do they react? Obviously, you want more experience at this level. Macy Heimlich of North White does a lot of things really good. She's the experienced player. Basically, this is the same regional as last year, except we're inserting Lakewood Park in there. So these other teams have a lot of experience. So it'll be interesting for Lakewood Park to see how they react. They've reacted good on big stages all year. Played Garrett down at Bankers Life. It was a 9 a.m. Saturday morning game. There was nobody in Bankers Life except for those two teams. But it's still a big environment, a completely different environment, and they thrived in that environment. So it'll be interesting to see how they do at Caston.
One of our resident Hall of Famers, Reggie Hayes, was able to catch up with Lakewood Park earlier this week.
A couple of our strength is, you know, just all-out effort. I ask them to give everything on the court at every time. So that is one of our greatest strengths. Another one I would say is, you know, we have a higher shooting percentage from our guards. And just being able to take care of the ball with our freshman point guard, she can handle the ball very well. So those are just a few of our strengths.
Lakewood Park will meet North White 10 a.m. in the first semifinal. The other semifinal, Oregon Davis and Marquette Catholic. Your thoughts on that game?
I think it's going to be a hard time for anybody in Class 1A to get by Marquette Catholic.
They're number one in the state by your notes here.
They are. Emma and Sophia Nolan, to show you the reach of Always 100 here locally, two of their premier players, 20 points, 8 rebounds, you know, 4 assists, 2.5 steals a game. Both of them, the twin sisters, average around that number. They're a very tough duo to get by. It's tough. Lakewood Park has a good shot in the morning, I think, against North White. If they play composed, you're going to run into a buzzsaw with Marquette Catholic. It's like getting to a chance to play Carmel in 4A. Yeah, you got there, but man, you're going to have to work hard to pull out a regional title win.
Saturday night, once all the dust clears, how many area teams do we have left?
One.
Do you want to name it?
I would say that Central Noble probably has the best chance of getting out of the regional. But with the caveat there that it's very, very tough for them. Bluffton is no pushover, peaking at the right time, a Bluffton team that's excited. As Coach Karl, Grau told me earlier this week, it's kind of a benefit to a team when you haven't been there. Central Noble's been there now. Last year was their big experience. What do we do? Sure. How do we deal in regional round and then in the semi-state round? But there's a benefit to kind of the ignorance is bliss. You haven't been there. Central Noble's got a tough run. Bluffton and probably North Judson St. Pierre that night. I would say that they're kind of in the best shape. And maybe at Columbia City, maybe a Fairfield or Concordia winner. Yeah. But right now, it's hard for me to bet against Marion. I did that in the sectional, and they proved me wrong. So I would say at best we're getting one out. Central Noble has the best shot for me, but could be zero.
I'll go Concordia. I like the way they played last week, taking care of Leo and then beating Angola, holding them to 39 points a week ago. So I like Concordia as the favorite. If we have any teams get out, I like Concordia the most. So next week we'll be back to talk semi-state, maybe, if we have any area teams left. Of course, plenty of boys basketball over the next couple weeks leading into the boys basketball tournament. So for Dan Vance, I'm Justin Kenny. Thanks for joining us.